Quick question.
The mics are clicking them on.
They are already on.
We will do it here. That's very exciting. Potentially at the end of the conference, I might say one more thing. You're going to be in the conference. All right, thank you.
I'll do my best.
Thank you.
very bad day. And as we were warming up tonight, I realized how happy and excited I was to be doing this. And there's something about that power of music that just can change your day. And never underestimate that power and what it means to adults, but also these students. It's a crazy world out there right now. And I kind of had an epiphany as I thought, oh my gosh, this is great. I forgot the rest of my day for me. Anyway, welcome. It seems like the world has completely sped up since March. March just took off and beat everybody to a pulp. And we have done nothing in the music department except go, go, go. Our indoor percussion ensemble was just in Dayton, Ohio for 4 or 5 days. We had students from our musical singing on Broadway, and our indoor color guard just won their local championships on Saturday. So it has been nonstop. In case you didn't notice at home, all the students have been zombies for about a month and a half. But here in our department, they keep working, which is really cool. And it's not always easy, and it's certainly not always fun, and it definitely doesn't always sound like the concert. But I'm really proud of the work they've done, and I'm very excited for them to share it with you this evening. Our next piece is quite different. It's a 20th century piece of music, so right away my wife's worried about it, because she knows what that can mean. 20th century music is often experimental and trying some different things. This piece is called Old Churches because it's supposed to evoke sounds that you might hear in an old church, whether it's creaking floorboards or old furnaces starting or even like remnants of voices still echoing from years ago. So this is quite different, but I hope you enjoy Michael Culbertson's Old Churches. Our final selection is Songs of Old Kentucky. If you've ever been to our percussion ensemble is just in Kentucky for their prelims. Even though the trip was to Ohio, we got to travel in Kentucky. I've never been in Kentucky before, so that was kind of cool. After this final piece, we'll take a few moments and switch things over to our jazz band, so we appreciate your patience. Thank you.
Thank you.
drums here. We'll bring the jazz band up. Thank you. Oh my gosh, this is so great up here. You should all come up sometime and just like listen this close. It's really pretty cool. Don't do that tonight, but when you get an opportunity. If you didn't just hear enough of Ryan Cairns, this next piece should take care of whatever your ears need to hear. This is Benny Carter's Evening Star, and it will also feature Alicia on piano.
Thank you.
not teach him any of that. That's great. So we're running a live stream, and I'm pretty sure no Malice is watching, our choir director. And at some point, I can't remember if it was a coincidence or what, but he said, you know, they're re-releasing a new updated version. I guess it's not re-release. They're releasing a new updated version of the 80s show, Night Court. You should play that theme. Coincidentally, I had just pulled it out like a day before to play with the band, because I always loved this one. Enjoy Night Court. Following this one, we'll need just a few minutes to get the concert band on stage.
Thank you.
not to say about these students behind me. Trying not to talk too much. I saw a video of one of her concerts one time, and I felt like I was fast-forwarding for me a lot, so I apologize in advance. This next song is a very meaningful song. It was composed in honor of a student that was killed. He was a baritone saxophone player. He was in Iowa, I believe, in the early 90s. They commissioned this piece to honor the student. And the piece actually tells the story of the morning of the car accident. And, you know, seems kind of morbid to bring that back, but it's part of the story. And you'll hear in the middle, you know, the foggy morning and just things kind of going strange. But what's important is the message at the end of celebrating this life of this fantastic student. And a few weeks before he was killed, he had written a poem for an English class, I believe it was. And the last few lines were just, or I'm sorry, the last line was, "I am." And so they use that in this piece, and you'll hear that sung by the band. So please enjoy "I Am."
Thank you.
told them I lost my notes. You don't want me making these announcements without notes, but I will do my best. First of all, that last piece, I don't know about you, but that got me. I haven't teared up for a while during the performance. And that one got me. That was, thank you. Thank you, Dan. Before we play our final selection, quite a number of thank yous. It's in the program. Thank you to basically the entire world for letting us do what we do. To our music producers who, for those of you not super very involved, I don't know if you realize the extent of what so many in this room do, and people that are watching on the stream. It's not just picking up and putting down equipment and moving things and what in a truck. There's so much behind the scenes, financial, organizational, and just really taking care of what our students need. It's amazing, so thank you to our boosters. To my family, this job requires a lot of hours and a lot of days away, so my dad's here, but he still comes to my concerts. Pull this down. And of course, my wife Amy, who puts up with an awful lot of complaining, and you name it. So Amy, thank you. I love you. And not in the family, but sort of. I started teaching at a small, I'm just going to say, backwoods high school in Indian Head, Maryland in 1994, I guess. And I'm still in touch with some of those students, and it's really cool that one of those students works in the Philly area, and every now and then will get in touch with me and say, what are you doing? We'll hang out. And he messaged me yesterday and said, what are you doing this week? I'm like, I got a concert. And he said, I'll be there. So Gabe Gallagher, so great to stay in touch. Music will support everyone. I do want to mention quickly our seniors. I'm not going to name them all. They got stars on their names in the program, but they are stars that you wouldn't believe. We all went through the COVID thing, and we're still going through it, I suppose. But these are the leaders in this group that have not given up. They didn't stop. I guess that's what giving up is. They just kept going, and whatever we as directors asked, they did it. And it's bringing us to nights like tonight, performances like what you're hearing. So to the seniors out there, thank you for your leadership and guidance and your just stick-to-itness. It really is making nights like tonight possible. Thank you, seniors. And lastly, I'm going to apologize if I missed some announcements that I had written down. I honestly have no idea where they went. On the way in, you may have seen a jar for the Matthew Bailey Scholarship. Matthew Bailey was a student here at Perkiomen Valley when I started. He was tragically lost in a plane accident in 1997. And we started a scholarship in his name, and that will go to one of our seniors in the music department. And if you didn't get a chance to make a donation on the way in, if you can on the way out, it's much appreciated. Thank you. Our last piece tonight is Corral and Shaker Dance, one of my all-time favorites. And coming back from COVID, a lot of music teachers had questions about what their students could do. And for whatever crazy reason, I decided instead of lowering the bar a little bit this year, I would raise it, see what happens. And if nothing else, they're going to learn a lot. So the bar is really high on this piece. And I'm very excited to see what happens in the next bunch of minutes. Please enjoy Corral and Shaker Dance.
Thank you.
arrived safely. Oh, I remembered my announcement. I didn't read the paper after all. Most of you know it, you'll probably repeat it, but we're gonna have a little party backstage. Really, two announcements. One, if we could get a few people to help load the truck, all of this fun stuff has to go back to the high school, and then once it gets to the high school, it gets unloaded. Now, I made that announcement at the winter concert, and I'm pretty sure the Lofton family unloaded that truck completely by themselves, so let's give them the night off on that part, and if we could get a bunch of people backstage, it really doesn't take long. Many hands make light work. And then I did send an email out to the jazz band parents. If you're available, if you could just meet me down in the front really quickly, we'll try to get things organized for tomorrow. Thank you all so much. Have a great night.